What's happening, everybody? Today, I'm super stoked to do this video for y'all. This is a video that I've wanted to do for a really, really long time, and I just haven't had the time to do it. But now with like the coronavirus pandemic, quarantine, all that, I had enough time to do everything. This is all of our saltwater fishing lures, and this is gonna be a full breakdown on the inshore saltwater fishing lures. Everything from soft plastics, hard plastics, bucktails, your metal baits, big game stuff, everything. Okay, so when it comes to soft plastics, Berkley GULP and Z-Mann are the two main brands. Berkley GULP is a little bit more expensive, but it has like a proprietary scent. It actually sits in Berkley GULP juice. So swimming mullet and shrimp are two of the top Berkley GULP soft plastics. So they also have others like the jerk shad right here. But for me and my tackle box, I pretty much have the swimming mullet. I use these primarily for flounder fishing, but with Berkley GULP, they're a little bit more expensive. The scent is amazing, but they're not as durable. So in the summertime, I don't use as much Berkley GULP because you just get what we call tail biters, and those are like bait fish. They just nip at it. And Berkley GULP is, it's very expensive and it just doesn't last that long. So in the summertime, I get a lot of questions about how can you eliminate tail biters with Berkley GULP. You can't. All you do is you use Z-Mann. Okay, so like Berkley GULP, when I use Berkley GULP mainly is gonna be like when the bite's slower, like in the winter time or the springtime. When the fish, their metabolism is a little bit slower and they're not feeding as actively and they need a little bit more motivation to eat your lure, then that's when I'll probably tend to use Berkley GULP a little bit more, is gonna be during those times. Not too much in the summertime, except for if I'm just targeting flounder, then I'll probably use this. So that will be in the summertime. So that's kind of the exception, is when I'm specifically targeting flounder, is when I'll use Berkley GULP. But Z-Mann I will use in all applications all year round. As you can see, it's a lot more durable. So this shrimp pattern works really well. So for Z-Mann, this right here is the Minnow Z, and this is a great all year round lure. This lure works great in the summertime. You can swim it across a flat. You can bounce it on the bottom. And then Z-Mann also has their shrimp right here. This is amazing. You can fish underneath of a popping cork, which a popping cork, we're not talking too much about rigs today. So if y'all don't know about popping corks, we have tons of videos on how to fish a popping cork, how to choose the right popping cork. So y'all definitely check those out. We're gonna leave a link in the description below, but this is a popping cork and it suspends your bait about 2 feet below the water surface, and you're gonna fish that with a 1/4 ounce jig head. And below a popping cork, I like to fish the shrimp. This shrimp right here, this is the root beer color Z-Mann, and this is a great color. I wanna show y'all. So this is a great color for darker stained water, like Louisiana, Outer Banks, Low Country, Charleston, Savannah. This is great, because especially, so the rule of thumb for lures, whether it's freshwater or saltwater, the darker the water, typically the darker the bait. But this is a great color. This is the root beer color. It's got a chartreuse tail, so it's got some gold flakes to it. This is an amazing soft plastic that I'm gonna use underneath of a popping cork, and I'm gonna pair that up with some Procure, of course. And you're gonna catch pretty much every inshore species on this. And then another favorite of mine is the Z-Mann Minnow Z. And my favorite colors are, this is Sexy Mullet right here. This works great in all water clarities. Creole Croaker is my number one favorite color for Z-Mann. And this is my favorite pattern. So this is a great wintertime soft plastic. In the winter, in the early spring, like right now, this is pretty much gonna be the main soft plastic lure that I use under a 1/4 ounce jig head or a 1/8 ounce jig head. So the weight of your jig head that you're fishing it on is going to dictate how slow or fast your lure is gonna fall in the water column. So in the winter time, I use a lighter jig head, either a 1/4 ounce or a 1/8 ounce jig head, fishing with this Z-Mann Minnow Z. A lighter jig head is gonna give you a slower fall rate. Those fish, they're moving slower in the winter time, so they want a slower moving bait. So that's why I'm gonna fish like a 1/8 ounce jig head, something much, much lighter, to keep the bait in the strike zone a little bit longer. So those right there, these I use all year round, but they're great in the winter and the spring because, so in the winter time, we don't have as much shrimp in our inshore waters. Our inshore game fish, they're keying in on just smaller bait fish all winter and spring long. So these are great. Again, you can swim them, you can jig them, you can just fish them a lot of different ways. Okay, so going back to Berkley GULP, this is their jerk shad, and this is another one of my favorite soft plastics. You can fish this all year round. Again, just watch out for those tail biters. If you keep getting, you know, your bait destroyed, then switch to Z-Man. Z-Man also has a jerk shad as well, and this just has a great darting action in the water. So you can jig it on the bottom, you can also kind of twitch your rod and give it like a darting action through the water column, but this jerk shad is great. Can fish all species all year round for the jerk shad as well. I really like this pink color. Striped bass and trout, I feel like they absolutely love pink, so I tend to use this mainly for those species. Okay, so just some final things with soft plastics. Some other lures that I like are the Swimming Trout Trick by Z-Man, a little bit more slender profile. This right here kind of imitates like a shrimp pattern, but it also has like a paddle tail. And this color right here, Electric Chicken, is great. So I use this for soft plastics and hard plastics. This is a great soft plastic that you can use all year round under a popping cork or straight to a jig head. Again, you can swim it, jig it, everything. So that's really the main benefit with soft plastics, is the versatility that they allow. Again, you can apply the specific action and technique to that bait. So you can also swim it across a flat, whether you're search casting for redfish or speckled trout. So, you know, just soft plastics, very versatile. So the DOA Bait Buster is great to use for snook, tarpon, and it's a great bait to use Florida, Texas. Y'all love these down south. So the DOA Bait Buster is another soft plastic that I have in my tackle box. And then we're gonna start talking about Mirrolure. But this is the Paul Brown. So what's up, all y'all in Texas? Y'all love the Paul Browns, fishing these on the flats in Texas. We use these a lot in the fall when our trout come up shallow on the flats and they're feeding on some of the larger bait fish. So these Paul Browns are very, very effective. It's got a slow, it's a very slow sinking, suspending, kind of twitch bait action. So it's got some great, great action. This is the Paul Brown by Mirrolure. So for hard plastics, all you gotta know is pretty much Mirrolure. These are my hard plastics right here. We have Topwater, and then we're gonna have our suspending and slow sinking Mirrolures right here. So I use pretty much these Mirrodines. Everything from, this is the double XL. I tend to use this mainly in the fall. This is a great fall bait, because it's a larger profile. In the fall, your speckled trout, redfish, and your inshore game fish, they're gonna be feeding on larger size mullet and just larger size bait fish. So Electric Chicken and Mardi Gras are my favorite colors for Mirrolure, as well as this one. I believe it's 808, but this is a highly, highly effective, but this is a great color for Mirrolure. So in the fall, I like to use the double XLs and the XLs, just a little bit larger profile. This is what our inshore fish are gonna be keying in on. This is the Mardi Gras color, another great, great color. And then if you're trolling from a kayak, then this right here is the 52MR. It's a slow sinking, head down just a little bit. And this is a great action when you're trolling behind the kayak. So this is a great Mirrolure that you wanna have in your tackle box as well. Then you've got some of your smaller profiles. This is the 17 and 18MR right here. This is just a smaller Mirrodine. It's actually the 18MR because it's the heavy Dean, and it's got a little bit of a faster sink rate to the just regular 17MR. So this is the heavy Dean. You can get longer casts on it and it's gonna sink a little bit faster. And it's just got, all these just have great action in the water. So what it's gonna do is it's gonna suspend or slow sink right there in the strike zone. And then you just twitch your rod. And it's just got some great, great action right here. So these are the Mirrodines. My favorite colors again, Mardi Gras right here and Electric Chicken. So these are great. Some other hard plastics that you want is gotta have topwater. If you don't like catching fish on topwater, then you're not living right. This is a Mirrolure. This is the Top Dog Junior, I believe. And this right here just has a great walk the dog side to side motion. Another topwater lure, this is the Chug Bug. And the Chug Bug is great for whether you're fishing up north for striped bass or down south for snook, but as you, it doesn't have as much of a side to side walk the dog motion. It has more of just, it pushes water. It's got that concave kind of front to it, so it's gonna push water, and this is great for striped bass. Really, really fun lure that you wanna have in your tackle box right here. Some other hard plastics that I have is the Rapala Skitter V10. I really like this color. This is another topwater, and it's got that great kind of side-to-side walk-the-dog motion to it. So that right there is pretty much it for my hard plastics. Now we're gonna move over and we're gonna talk about bucktails and just some of the other inshore saltwater fishing baits. So when you're cobia fishing, this right here is all you need to know right here is a bucktail. This is a 2 ounce bucktail. This is what I like to use. This is a bowed up 2 ounce bucktail made by Bowed Up Lures. And I'll actually show y'all, this is my cobia fishing setup. And I like to fish a 2 ounce bucktail. I use a loop knot just to give that natural action to it. The colors that I like to use, you know, this is just from talking to some old timers and some of my guide friends, is that they tell me that orange kind of mimics more of like a crab. That's what like the cobia sees, is like a crab. And you know, the natural colors like this mimics more of like a bait fish. Either way, you want to have a bucktail whether you're fishing on the boat or on the pier, because the last thing you want to see if you're fishing on the pier is a school of cobia swim by and you've got nothing to throw at them. So a 2 ounce bucktail, definitely want to have. You know, you're going to be using 40 to 50 pound leader line, and you guys definitely have to have a bucktail in your inshore saltwater fishing tackle box. Bucktails are just a staple inshore saltwater fishing lure. These are some smaller bucktails. This is like a 1/2 ounce bucktail. This is, I believe, like a 1 ounce bucktail. These you can use for everything. Trout, flounder, redfish, everything. But these are very popular for flounder fishing. So if you're flounder fishing, say like Chesapeake Bay Bridge Tunnel in my backyard, or you're fishing some offshore wrecks or artificial reefs off the coast of North Carolina, Florida, wherever, then bucktails, these ones are gonna be great right here. So you wanna have some bucktails. You can also tip these with some Berkley GULP, and just to give it a little bit more scent, a little bit more action. Or you can even put Procure on the bucktail itself. That's something that we do as well. So then some other inshore saltwater fishing lures that you're gonna wanna have is, this right here is a Clark spoon. These are our metal baits, and this is what you use to troll for Spanish mackerel, bluefish. And you've got these sea strikers right here, and these, we have a full tutorial on how to use these, but this is my trolling setup right here. So you use this on a boat. If you don't have a boat, then you're gonna wanna use a gotcha plug. And I don't have one with me because right now we're quarantined and you know everything's pretty much closed right now. So I'll have some footage here showing y'all what a gotcha plug looks like. We'll have a link in the description below. Gotcha plugs are amazing. If you're just land-based, you're fishing off of piers, you have to have a gotcha plug for sure. It's one of the most fun ways to catch your inshore saltwater fish, Spanish mackerel, bluefish. We've even caught cobia on a gotcha plug. Christy, my wife, has. That was awesome. Some of the other trolling setups is you have like these Yozuri crystal minnows, and these are great for trolling Spanish mackerel, even king mackerel. Just everything hits this Yozuri right here. So a great nearshore, inshore trolling lure right here. And you can also cast it as well. So Yozuri, this is a great inshore saltwater fishing lure. And then you've got these Manns. This is, you've got like the stretch 20s, stretch 25s. These are what you use for striped bass fishing, primarily like in the Chesapeake Bay. Next thing is, we've got some of our flies that I wanted to show y'all for inshore saltwater fly fishing. We've got some of these little like sand flea imitations. These are great for pompano. We've got clousers, which are great for really everything. You know, just imitates like a bait fish. As you can see, it looks very similar to this electric chicken, like Mirrolure color. So these are great for speckled trout, redfish, false albacore, and this is a great Spanish mackerel fly right here. It's like it imitates a glass minnow. But my favorite for inshore saltwater fly fishing is going to be this shrimp pattern right here. So this shrimp pattern, you got the two brass beads up here in the front that, you know, give it a little bit more weight. And then on the back, check that out. It's got like actually like the eyes in the back, and that looks really cool, very realistic. So this right here is what we've been catching all of our redfish on the fly. And this is our, actually right here. So this is our fly fishing setup, and we'll be doing a lot more saltwater fly fishing. And this is our Orvis Helios 3, actually. It's our 8-weight. So anyways, the shrimp pattern, deadly, gets it done all over. So anyways, y'all, so that right there is a fundamental breakdown on just inshore saltwater fishing lures, what I have in my tackle box, when I use it, and why I use it. Hopefully that helps y'all out, and that's all I got for y'all today. You guys get up off your butt, go catch yourself some fish. Peace out.